after watching this game, I feel like it dawned on me the importance of Wayne Gallman, why he's on this team. I mean, just looking at the depth chart there, Mostert's the best player, but he has durability issues, so you need someone else. That's why they drafted Trey Sermon, but he's a rookie. You have no idea what Trey Sermon's going to give you. Also, Jamichael Hasty, I like him a lot. Hasn't played much, fumbled in the preseason game. You don't know. Gallman is just so known. You know exactly what he's going to give you. He was the number two guy last year, started a bunch of games when Saquon Barkley got hurt, averaged 4.6 yards per carry. He's freaking dependable, and he's a good fit with Trey Lance because he played in college with Deshaun Watson. He's very used to lining up in the shotgun and running the zone read. He's an important player for this team because he's a known quantity.
Yeah, so first, I love the running back room. I love the depth. So starting at the top with Mostert, I don't think there's much to say on him other than if he's healthy, he's lethal. Going on to Trey Sermon, Sermon showed that he can be a little bit of a bruiser, and I like that element because Mostert is not. And with Jeff Wilson, who's really our best goal line back and all-purpose running back, being out, I think Sermon, hopefully. But like you said, you don't know. It's an unknown. I have hope for Sermon. I saw a little bit from him that I feel like, no, nothing was bad here. It just wasn't great. Moving on to Gallman. Gallman had some good runs, especially to the outside, which is great to see because, as you said, that pairs well with Lance. I felt like he did his assignments correctly. There was nothing overly flashy, but there was nothing particularly wrong in what Gallman did. So Gallman is a spellback. He's just going to spell Mostert the workload to keep him healthy. Sermon as well, and Gallman's insurance to Sermon if one of the two of them gets injured, because if Mostert gets injured, then it goes Sermon and Gallman. And that's, I don't think we will be in the fire if that happens, but I do think that losing Mostert is it cannot happen. That's where they're important. Jamichael Hasty, go ahead. You had something
Real quick, you had mentioned earlier that like just Lance being on the field is going to supercharge the run game. When they put him on the field with the offense, with the first team offense for two plays a day now in practice, that's what they've gotten him to. And every time it's him in the shotgun, zone read, handoff. They don't let him keep it. They don't let him throw it in front of the media at least. So, and what you see is 20-yard runs up the middle from Sermon, Gallman. He runs that zone read with Gallman and Sermon, not Mostert as much. Mostert's more of an I-formation guy. So I think what we're seeing is when they do run this and they run it with Lance, Gallman's going to have big runs. He, like, as Gavin points out here, he didn't really have him in this
game. Because of the cars.
Yeah,
he did not, just like he did not suit Lance, he did not suit Gallman. Gavin, you're right. He didn't look like much during the Chiefs. Neither did Trey Lance. Didn't look like much at all.
No, because Kyle Shanahan made a choice not to show what he's been showing in practice because he wants to keep the element of surprise. I totally understand. Just don't get your quarterback hurt in preseason. Please, please. Hasty says, John says Hasty looks hungry. Yeah, man. His legs look way bigger. It looks like he's an NFL player. I believe in him. He may have to start the season on the practice squad, though. Although, if he keeps playing, like, he may not make
that fumble. That came on second effort, though.
It did. He was almost down. Yeah.
But you know how they say either you have to just learn to get down. In regular season, you're going to hear so many analysts say, oh, that fumble. It's, you know, this is why they say you just got to accept that you're tackled sometime and get down. That's what that was. But he's in preseason. He's trying to carve out a role for himself against an enormous depth chart. I had no problem with that fumble because what an effort to fumble that ball. I mean, just bent out and everything. It was... I'm okay with that. I don't worry about that.
Final is Elijah Mitchell. I'm interested about him. I mean, he's hurt. He was a 6th-round pick. It seems like the Niners are creating the opportunity of, like, put him on IR, redshirt him. They've done this with 6th-round picks in the past. Tim Harris Jr. comes to mind. So curious to see what happens. If he plays in a preseason game, we can take him seriously. But until then, it's looking like IR for his rookie season.